வெல்கம் பேக் டு யூடியூப் வியூவர்ஸ். இன்னைக்கு நம்ம பேச போறோம் வித் மிஸ்டர் கோபாலகிருஷ்ணன், ஹூ பிளேஸ் அ வெரி கீ ரோல் இன் பப்ளிக் சர்வீஸ். வணக்கம் கோபாலகிருஷ்ணன் சார், பிளீஸ் இன்ட்ரோடியூஸ் யுவர் செல்ஃப்.
மை செல்ஃப் இஸ் அன் அட்வொகேட். ஐ ஸ்டார்டட் மை ப்ராக்டிஸ் ஃப்ரம் 1980 ஆன்வர்ட்ஸ். இட் நியர்லி 40 இயர்ஸ் ஐ கம்ப்ளீட்டட் மை ப்ரொஃபஷன். I was doing for all nationalized banks. I was appearing for all the insurance companies, and I was appearing for the all the leading companies in Tamil Nadu and all over India also. I appeared in other states also in cases in Bangalore, Hyderabad, Delhi High Courts, and all the courts in Tamil Nadu and India.
Okay.
I appeared.
ஏதாவது கேசஸ் உங்களுக்கு ஞாபகம் இருக்கா?
Yeah, I appeared lot of cases and numerous cases, and mostly in the central government. I was a standing counsel for central government. I also helped some of the petitioner advocates who are appearing for senior citizens, but I used to help them also for quick disposal of the senior citizen cases. But even though you have got every right, when you come to the high court you can file an application and you can take up the cases, maybe take up early as a senior citizen. You have got a privilege also for taking the case in the high court.
So senior citizen kun, there are certain privileges that they can avail.
Yes, definitely in the court they will avail. Even in the railway stations they will have it. Tickets they will get. And even all places, even when you go to for any petty cases also, if you are a senior citizen, then your case will be taken up and disposed of within 2 or 3 months maximum.
And what about any discount in fee? Do senior citizens
fees are equal for all the persons. There is no specific discount for senior citizen, but which you can get it in Indian Airlines. Indian Airlines you can get the discount for the senior citizens. You will have some percentage of discount in the Indian Airlines.
Okay.
Yeah.
What about women and women senior citizens? அவங்களுக்கு are there any special privileges in our courts in India?
No.
அப்படி இல்ல. There are situations where in case the son and daughter-in-law don't take care. அப்போ இப்போ off late there is a rule, there is a law that says that the parents can file a case.
Yes.
Against their own
Even senior citizens, they are entitled to get maintenance from their children. Even though the children are 50 and above, this father and mothers are senior citizens, they are entitled to get the maintenance from their sons and daughters. So there is a privilege, is there is a also act is there. Even in the IPC criminal procedure also, you will get a maintenance by filing a maintenance case against the children. The father and mother is entitled for it.
Okay. Adhe mari, is there anything other than writing a will for any other mode by which periyunga ellam vandu seniors la vandu thanoda pillaingalukku property o assets o equal a divide pannu, however they want to do it?
They can do it by way of settlement deed.
Settlement deed.
Only the settlement deed is the percentage of stamps also very less. But when you execute as a sale deed, it is only 7+4%. But here the settlement deed is very nominal, the notional value is fixed.
What is a settlement deed? How can senior
any father and mother, they are executing the, instead of executing the will, they can execute the settlement deed.
Okay.
Suppose if they execute the will in Madras, the will is to be probated in the High Court. So that is instead of going to the High Court, you can straight away execute the settlement deed and register it in favor of your children instead of executing the will at Chennai.
So who should they approach for executing a settlement deed? Approach
the advocate, proper advocate. He will guide you properly for executing the settlement.
Okay. That is easier and cheaper way of distributing.
Even if the property goes for 1 crore, you can pay only 25,000 rupees stamp.
Okay.
So that is like that. Yeah, the government is giving some thing for the parents to give the execute the document by way of settlement deed.
Okay.
So that is advisable.
Will there be a difference? Will there be a probate for
the law? Will.
So, are there any explain? What is the difference between the will and the settlement deed?
Yes. Suppose the will means, if you execute a will, there should be two witnesses, and the will is to be, if the will is executed at Chennai, Madras, it is to be probated. Suppose if the will is executed at Chengalpet or Madurai, it need not be probated. Suppose if the will is executed at Bangalore, that is also not necessary. Probating is not necessary. Only the four places, Chennai, Bombay, Calcutta, Delhi. These are the four places where if you execute a will, it is to be probated. Other than these places, if you execute any will, need not be probated. Will can be directly, once the party is on the person is diseased, when they immediately you have to produce a death certificate along with the will, the property will be transferred in your name automatically.
Probate charges only, sir.
But if you go for probate, you have to go for publication, paper publication. That is a, and you have to give notices to all your legal heirs. All your, suppose if the property is given to one of the only son, and the other two sons are there, you have to give the notice to other two sons also. And they have to come to the court and say that my father has executed the will, hence we are not claiming, we are not objecting it. Suppose if they object it, it will be converted into testamentary suit in the High Court. So that is also there. So that is why it is advisable to go and execute a settlement deed instead of executing a will.
And the probate charges,
probate charges, na, that is also nominal charges. Now previously it was 4% and other things. Now it has been reduced by the government. Only 25,000 rupees for the probating charge or whatever it may be the value of the property. You have to pay only 25,000 rupees when you go for probate in the High Court. Yes. Yeah.
Now, what happens if somebody does interstate?
Interstate means everyone will get an equal share. If father is died interstate, there are four children. So all the four children will get one share, one fourth share. Then they have to execute either the release deed or whatever it may be to settle themselves among the, suppose if the wife is alive, wife is also entitled for one share. And if the mother is alive, mother is also getting one share. And the children also will get one share. That is an equal share. Everybody, son and daughter, everybody will get one share. Even the mother of the deceased also will get one share. The father of the deceased will not get one share.
What about HUF?
These are things, this is a principle carries on. This is a principle. Notarized means that is only the attestation of the document. Suppose if you have original, you have to produce before the notary public, then it will be attested. So when the notary is attesting the document, then it will be treated as a original. It is a copy of the original, it is attested, it is confirmed, it will be confirmed by the notary that the original is available. That is the only thing for the notarizing. Suppose if the document, if some company indemnity to be executed, it is to be attested by the notary. So what is attestation means, if you have to go to the notary public office and you have to sign before him. Once you sign before the notary, it will be countersigned by the notary and put the seal. So automatically it is an attested copy. That is your signature was attested. Suppose if you are sending it outside that means you the person signed. That was identified by the notary. So that is why the notary is there. Yes.
So, normally in the notarized, what are the documents which require notary public?
Affidavit, all the affidavits are required to be notarized, and general power of attorney is to be notarized, and will also they are getting it notarized. Suppose if you are executing, if anyone is in foreign country, you have to send the power of attorney. So, when you send the power of attorney, they will get the signature from the notary public from that country. Suppose in Australia or Canada, England, over, they will get the signature from that country. Once they get the signature, they will send back to the India. When it comes to India, it is to be adjudicated with the registrar office within a month's time. So that is also there. So once it is adjudicated, automatically that document is valid to do for registration and other works in India.
Okay, lot of people misuse it. Real estate la property ku power of attorney kudukuranga adu misuse aayidu. Indha prevent pannadhukku power of attorney kuduttingana eppadi cancellation adukku enna la procedure
power of attorney cancellation. Suppose if you are giving a power, if you want to cancel the power of attorney, you have to issue a legal notice to the concerned party attorney. We are revoking the power of, once you give the legal notice, automatically it will be revoked. Even though document is registered, suppose if anything done after issuing the legal notice, that will become null and void.
But prior to legal notice, it is valid.
Yes, that is valid. Prior to legal notice, it is valid. Once you give the legal notice, automatically all the documents subsequent to the legal notice are invalid.
So, sir, US lala vandu, there is notary on wheels. Adhiya India la innu amal paduthala, pannalama.
But anga notary on wheels na, you see, the in foreign countries, no notary is an advocate. Here, the advocates are only appointed as a notary. That is the difference. No notary can go and practice in the court. So, he is specifically appointed for the purpose of notarizing a document by that state.
Okay.
He is not an advocate. He need not be an advocate.
Okay. He is only a notary.
Yeah, notary.
Okay.
So, here the advocates are appointed by the state government is appointing the advocate as a notary. State government and central government are appointing.
Okay.
So, no other persons are appointing the notary. Well, the notary is appointed by state government or central government.
Notary is a qualification. What is the procedure?
Suppose if you want to be a notary, you must have minimum 10 years practice. 10 years practice in the bar, and you have to get the recommendation. That is, suppose if you are applying for notary, it is to be recommended by some officials. That is just like that banks, nationalized bank, insurance, over it. So they want 12 persons to be up. There are 12 persons. They have to recommend you for appointing as a notary. And on receipt of this application only, the government will consider it and appoint a notary.
So, generally, sir, what is your guideline to help senior citizens? What is it you would like to advise them?
I would like advise, even in the banks, the RBI has framed the rules to all the banks to give assistance for the senior citizen. Suppose if you are a senior citizen, you can approach any bank, any nationalized bank or OBM, as per the RBI guidelines. You can insist the bank official to come to your house to collect the check. That is also there for the senior citizen. Senior citizens are entitled for it. That is, the rules were framed by the RBI, Reserve Bank of India. So that guidelines is there, and all the banks are bound by it. That no one can deny it. No one can say no. I cannot send any person at your residence for collecting checks or making the payment, whatever it may be. But as per the RBI guidelines, it is a must. You are entitled for it. All the senior citizens are entitled. They can ask the bank manager to send somebody to collect the check and represent it, or they can, even if you want any encashment also, you can send through them. That is also there as per the RBI guidelines.
Sir, innonu vande the bill ezhudumbodhu, what is the difference between self-owned property and ancestral property, which is, you know, when you write a will, when you say self-acquired property, ancestral property, and the will of padikumbodhu, how does the right differ on the two?
Yeah, suppose ancestral property, you inherited from your parents. When you inherit from the parents, you will become the absolute owner. That is, then only you are entitled to execute the will. Suppose if you are purchase the property, then you are the absolute owner, you can execute the will. In both the cases, you are entitled for it. And only suppose if you are getting it by way of inheritance, suppose if some other brothers or co-persons are there, they will question if you are not doing genuinely. That is the only thing. When you get the inheritance, you can get it by way of partition deed. When you get the partition deed, you yourself will be separated from your brother. So that is the inheritance problem. Suppose you are inheriting the property, you have two brothers. So both the brothers are dividing the property by way of partition. Once the partition is done, you will become the absolute owner. You can execute the will. So that co-person will not question your property. So that is necessary.
இப்போ வந்து ஒரு ஹஸ்பண்ட் அண்ட் ஒய்ஃப் இருக்காங்க. ஹஸ்பண்டோ ஒய்ஃபோ இறந்து போயிடுறாங்க. அப்போ அவங்களோட ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி வந்து ஒருத்தர் மேலே வரும், ஒய்ஃபுக்கோ ஹஸ்பண்டுக்கோ வரும். பசங்க வேறு இருக்காங்கன்னு வச்சுக்கோங்களேன், அந்த பசங்க கிளைம் பண்ணலாமா, இல்லை ஈக்குவல் ஷேர் போயிடுமா, அது ஒன்று. ரெண்டாவது இவங்க அப்புறம் இறந்து போயிட்டாங்கன்னு வச்சுக்கோங்க, தே பிகம் தி அப்சல்யூட் ஓனர்ஸ், தென் தே கேன் வில் இட் டு எனிபடி ஆஃப் தேர் சாய்ஸா, இல்லை அது பண்ண முடியாது, ஹஸ்பண்ட் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி பையனுக்கு தான் போய் சேரணுமா?
சப்போஸ் ஹஸ்பண்ட் ஒய்ஃப் ரெண்டு பேர் இருக்காங்க, தே ஆர் ஹேவிங் டூ சில்ட்ரன்ஸ், ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி இஸ் பர்ச்சேஸ் பை த ஹஸ்பண்ட், ஹி ஹிம்செல்ஃப் ஹஸ் பர்ச்சேஸ் த ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி. சப்போஸ் இஃப் ஹி டைட் இன்டர்ஸ்டேட், ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கலி த ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி கோஸ் டு ஆல் த ஒய்ஃப் அண்ட் சில்ட்ரன், டூ சில்ட்ரன். அண்ட் இஃப் த மதர் இஸ் அலைவ், சப்போஸ் இஃப் த ஃபாதர் இஸ் டைட், ஃபாதர்ஸ் மதர் இஸ் அலைவ், ஸோ ஷி வில் ஆல்சோ கெட் ஒன் ஷேர், ஷீ வில் ஆல்சோ கெட் ஒன் ஷேர், அண்ட் அப்பார்ட் ஃப்ரம் ஒய்ஃப் இஸ் ஆல்சோ கெட்டிங் ஒன் ஷேர், அண்ட் சன் அண்ட் டாட்டர் வில் கெட் ஒன் ஷேர், ஸோ ஆல் த ஃபோர் வில் கெட் ஈக்குவல் ஷேர். சப்போஸ் இஃப் த ஃபாதர் அண்ட் மதர் ஹஸ் பர்ச்சேஸ் த ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி, ஃபாதர் ஹஸ் எக்ஸிக்யூட்டட் எ வில் இன் ஃபேவர் ஆஃப் ஒய்ஃப் அண்ட் டைட், ஸோ ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்லி த ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி கோஸ் டு த ஒய்ஃப் இன்ஸ்டெட் ஆஃப் அதர் லீகல் ஹேர்ஸ். ஈவன் தோ அதர் லீகல் ஹேர்ஸ் ஆர் அவைலபிள், இட் வில் கோ டு ஒய்ஃப், அப்சல்யூட் ரைட். ஸோ ஷி ஹேஸ் டு கோ டு த கோர்ட் அண்ட் கெட் இட் ப்ரொபேட்டட் அண்ட் ஷி வில் கெட் ஆல் த ரைட்ஸ். அண்ட் சப்போஸ் இஃப் ஷி வாண்ட்ஸ் டு எக்ஸிக்யூட் எனி ப்ராப், சப்போஸ் இஃப் தட் வில் இஸ் கிவிங் பவர் டு ஹர் அப்சல்யூட்லி, தென் ஷீ கேன் எக்ஸிக்யூட் எனி வில் டு எனி தேர்ட் பார்ட்டி ஆல்சோ, நாட் இக்னோரிங் த சன்ஸ் அண்ட் டாட்டர்ஸ். த வில் இஸ் எக்ஸிக்யூட்டட் பை த ஹஸ்பண்ட் இன் ஃபேவர் ஆஃப் இஸ் ஒய்ஃப், அப்சல்யூட்லி இன் ஃபேவர் ஆஃப் இஸ் ஒய்ஃப் ரிகார்டிங் த ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி, ஷீ வில் கெட் எம்டே ரைட் ஓவர் த ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி அண்ட் த வில் ஆஸ் பர் த வில், அண்ட் இஃப் த வில் இஸ் ப்ரொபேட்டட் ஷீ கேன் எக்ஸிக்யூட் எனி வில் ஆர் எனி செட்டில்மெண்ட் இட் ஈவன் டு தேர்ட் பார்ட்டி. Suppose if the document is executed in favor of wife, absolute right. Suppose wife died intestate without leaving any will or anything, it automatically go to the legal heir, son and daughter. Even though husband, father has executed a will in favor of wife, wife died intestate, so automatically the property goes to the sons and daughters. So that is that. That cannot be questioned.
சரி, இப்போ வந்து இந்த கிளாஸ் லீகல் லீகல் ஹேர் கிளாஸ் சொல்கிறாங்க, யூனோ கிளாஸ் ஒன் கிளாஸ் டூ வாட் எவர் தே கிவ் யூ டிஃப்ரெண்ட், யார் யாருக்கு எந்தெந்த ரைட், எந்தெந்த கிளாஸ் லீகல் கிளாஸ் ஹேர் வருதுன்றது. ஸோ அது ஃபஸ்ட்டு ஒரு ஒருத்தர் இருந்து போனார்னா யார் வந்து க்ளோசஸ்ட் ஹேர் அண்ட்
கிளாஸ் ஒன் இஸ் அ ஃபஸ்ட். ஸோ கிளாஸ் ஒன் இஸ் அ சப்போஸ் இஃப் த ஃபாதர் இஸ் டைட், ஃபாதர்ஸ் மதர் இஸ் ஷீ இஸ் அ கிளாஸ் ஒன் ஹேர் அண்ட் ஒய்ஃப் She is a class 1 heir and children are the class 1 heirs. So this is a class 1. Class 2 heir is there. When it is comes, so class 2 heir, father is right. Father's father is coming under class 2 heir. So these are the things that are there. So
even if there is no one, you go into class 3.
Brothers and the mother.
Okay. So this is a very clear case, sir, yes. Where you know, where how you must. Now, the will is going to be explained. The will is there. வில்லில் என்னெல்லாம் நம்ம ஸ்பெசிஃபிக்காக எழுதுறோம், ஒரு ஒரு ஓல்டு மேன் ஒரு ஒரு பர்சன் ஹேஸ் டு ரைட் அ வில், யங் ஆர் ஓல்டு வாட் எவர், வாட் எக்ஸாக்ட்லி ஷுட் பி த ஃபார்மேட் ஆஃப் த வில்.
வில்லு வந்து என்ன ஒன்றும் எழுதலாம் ஃபஸ்ட் திங், தேர் இஸ் நோ ரெஸ்ட்ரிக்ஷன், ஒன்லி திங் தேர் ஷுட் பி டூ விட்னஸஸ், தட் இஸ் மேண்டேட்ரி. சப்போஸ் இஃப் யூஆர் எக்ஸிக்யூட்டிங் த வில், தேர் ஷுட் பி டூ விட்னஸஸ் and the person who is get beneficiary is entitled to provide that. So you have to give the will to the beneficiary. Suppose if you are executing a will and giving to one of the son or daughter, you have to give it to the will to the beneficiary, and in that will there should be two witnesses. So two witnesses should be independent witnesses. The two witnesses should not be related to either beneficiary or executor.
இப்போ இந்த வில்லு நீங்கள் சொன்னீங்க, என்ன வேணால் சப்ஸ்டன்ஸ் எழுதலாம், என்ன வேணால் எழுதலாம்னு சொல்ல இல்லையா. இப்போ வந்து சில பேருக்கு வந்து இந்த வில்லை வந்து ஃபோர்ஜ் பண்ணுறாங்க, அவங்க ஒரு வில்லை எழுதலைன்னா கூட அதை ஃபோர்ஜ் பண்ணிடுறாங்க. ஸோ ஹூ இஸ் டு ப்ரூவ் இந்த வில்லு எங்கள் அப்பா எழுதலை, எங்கள் அம்மா எழுதலை அப்படின்றது ஒரு டிஸ்பியூட் வரும் இல்லையா. அப்போது இப்போ ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் நோட்டரைஸே பண்ணிட்டு கொண்டுறான்னு வச்சுக்கோங்க, இதான் வில்லுன்னு அவங்க அப்பா இன்ட்ரெஸ்டேட்டாக இறந்துடுறாரு, வில்லை ஃபோர்ஜ் பண்ணுறாங்க, இதை எப்படி ஹூ இஸ் டு ப்ரூவ் தட் திஸ் வில் இஸ் ஃபோர்ஜ் ஆர் ஜெனுவின்.
That is, suppose if we are making the, if we are defending the case, we have to prove, and we have to produce certain documents, other documents signed by the same person. Suppose if the father is executed, the father has executed some other will in some other document, you produce that document and say in the court, So these are the, this is his name, this is a forged document. Only thing you have to prove to the court only. You have to come to the court to prove the case.
So unga job, the advocate's job advocate is to prove that something is not a forgery,
yes,
or anything like that. Very good, sir. Sir, other than all this, do you have any advice to senior citizens? Other one, then you brief a camera for solla. Anything you feel they should safeguard themselves, how they can safeguard the door, chinna brief.
Sir, senior citizens, my advice is you have to be very careful when you travel in bus or train, or and you will get the privilege in both train, railway station, airway and bus. Everywhere you are getting privilege. Even in the temple also you are giving the privilege for worshipping the god. So you have to use the privileges. You may not aware of all these things. Sometimes you may not, some illiterate peoples, they are not aware of it, and unnecessarily they are some third parties will interfere and enrich themselves because of your innocence. Please try to understand, you have got privilege in all places, even in temple, temples, banks and transportation services, everywhere you are getting privilege. Kindly utilize the services, and whatever help you want, you contact me, I will do my best. I am S. Gopalakrishnan, advocate, Notary Public. I was a Central Government Standing Counsel for Madras High Court. I am having my office at Lakshmi Siloam, 111/56, Kutchery Road, Mylapore, Chennai, 6 lakh 4. My phone number is 9 8 4 1 4 4 0 3 2 9 9 4 4 0 1 9 3 2 9. My landline is 0 4 4 2 4 6 4 0 3 2 9.
Thank you so much, sir, for finding the time to come and talk to YouTubers. I'm sure they will all benefit from whatever you have told them. Thank you so much.
Thank you.